was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was mine too, till I met you. I was breathing but not alive, and all my failures I tried to hide. It was my sin till I met you. You called my life.
give life, you love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore, every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you, only. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you, only.
Shout your praise, our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise.
Okay, so today's story is in Acts, and Acts takes place after Jesus died on the cross, his body was buried in the tomb, and he rose again. He walked around on earth, and then he ascended up into heaven. And so we jump into Acts where people are finding out about Jesus in different ways. And this particular story is about a man named Stephen. And we find out that Stephen is just incredibly passionate about telling people about Jesus. And so he is going all over telling people the truth about who Jesus is and that he is the Savior. And there are some people that don't like what Stephen is saying. They don't want him to be talking about this because it kind of goes against everything they thought they believed. And so they're not liking this truth that Stephen is talking about. They're not wanting to believe the truth about Jesus. And so they take Stephen and they take him in front of the Jewish high priest, which is the group of people that decide what's right or wrong. And Stephen gets in front of the Jewish high priest, and it says, it's so interesting, it says in Acts that Stephen's face looked like an angel's. And the Jewish high priest saw this. He's like, man, this man even looks different. Like his appearance is different. And you know why that was? Because Stephen had the Holy Spirit inside of him. And so his face looked like an angel. And there, in Acts, it outlines everything that Stephen says. And he's just telling the truth boldly about Jesus to these group of people. And they are getting angry and angrier and angrier because they don't like what he has to say. They don't want to believe this truth. And then I want to read this specifically to you. It's Acts 7:54. And it says, when they heard this, so the Jewish high priest, they were furious and gnashed their teeth at him. Can you guys picture that? Being so mad that you're gnashing your teeth at someone, and they were doing that to Stephen. But Stephen, full of the Holy Spirit, looked up to heaven and saw the glory of God. And Jesus, he looks up, he sees the glory of God, and then he sees Jesus standing at the right hand of God. Look, he said, I see heaven open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. That's what Stephen says. At this, they covered their ears and yelled at the top of their voices. They rushed at him, dragged him out of the city, and began to stone him. So back in the day, if someone got in trouble or you didn't like what someone was doing, you would take a stone, a big heavy stone, and they would throw it at people. And that's what they did to Stephen for telling them about the truth of Jesus. So they stoned him. And meanwhile, the witnesses laid their clothes at the feet of a young man named Saul. Okay, hint, remember that, because next week we're going to be talking about Saul. So they took their clothes and laid them at the feet of a man named Saul. And while they were stoning him, Stephen prayed. Y'all ready for this? Stephen prays. He talks to God and he says, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Then he fell on his knees and cried out, Lord, do not hold this against them. And when he said this, he fell asleep. This is a wild story. But this is what happened to Stephen when he told the truth of Jesus. And I see something that's sort of sad about it, but I also see something really amazing about God in this. So here's what I want you guys to discuss. Okay, here's the question. And this is like, you're going to really need to put like your thinking caps on. What does this story tell us about what can happen when we tell people about Jesus? What does this story tell us? And what does it tell us about God? And what does it tell us about people? That what happens when we tell people about Jesus? Okay, y'all have the discussion. Okay, that was kind of a hard question, wasn't it? Here's the thing that I see in this story, is that you and I, we need to tell people about Jesus. It's really important that we go and we tell people about the truth of Jesus. And sometimes people aren't gonna wanna hear it. We might get made fun of. we're probably not going to get stoned. I mean, but we might get made fun of. We might get rejected. People might think we're crazy. But it should not keep us from telling people about the truth of Jesus, just like Stephen. And the other thing that I love about this story is that when we tell people about Jesus, you know who always takes care of us? You know who always shows up? Even when we might be rejected, God always shows up. And did you see what happened to Stephen? He looked and he saw heaven in the middle of this. He saw Jesus in the middle of this. And I think even in the middle of us maybe telling someone about Jesus and them rejecting us or them thinking we're crazy, you know who always shows up? God. He always shows up. All right, I'm gonna pray for us. God, help us to be bold like Stephen to tell people the truth about who you are. We want to experience you. We want to see you like Stephen did. And help us be obedient. Help us to go and tell people about you, Jesus. In your name I pray, amen.
For this day, we're gathered in your name, calling out to you. Your glory like a fire, awakening desire, will burn our hearts with truth. You're the reason we're here. You're the reason we're singing. Your glory on our face, we're looking to the sky. Descending like a cloud, you're standing with us now. Lord, unveil our eyes. You're the reason we're here. You're the reason we're sitting.